A composed-looking Melvin Dummar arrived at the courthouse for a day of tedious questioning. An attorney representing Hughes' relatives led off by labeling Dummar's story as to how he got the will a fairy tale. "I suggest you invented this," said Paul Fries, "to appeal to religious people and then to the Hollywood crowd with a Cinderella notion." Then Fries suggested that Dummar's wife Bonnie wrote the will after Dummar researched it. To back this up, Fries pointed to the misspelling of Dummar in the Mormon will exhibit and got the witness to admit that his wife had once said she wished they could spell their name D-U-M-A-R instead of with two M's. Fries suggested that she wrote their name that way in the will to throw off investigators.
Well, the implications, suggestions, and statements in the court are that the two of them have collaborated in some way to put this document together through research and drafting. And the court record is just limited to those suggestions, and I think it ought to be noted that that's all the court record has developed so far.
During the afternoon session, Fries tried to link Dummar's aunt Bonnie with the will by claiming she possessed a collection of various handwritten wills. But nothing worked to shake Dummar's story, and the witness admitted to being bored by the questions. He wasn't the only one. Attorney Harold Roden busily sketched an amazing likeness of the witness instead of taking notes, a drawing that became a much sought-after souvenir. The proceedings should wrap up tomorrow, and so far no one has proved that Dummar is lying. However, Judge Keith Hayes at the end of today's session did order Dummar to return to Nevada if the will goes to trial to appear as a witness. This is Sarah Edwards for News Center 8.